In this video episode, I'm going to help you on how to do basic PLC programming by using GX Developer for your Mitsubishi PLC activities. Mitsubishi PLCs like FX2N series uses GX Developer 8 software, and we are going to use a 48MR model PLC. First, we need to identify the PLC programming requirements. This is our Mitsubishi FX2N 48MR, a compact and relay-type programmable logic controller. This is the input module where the sensing devices such as toggle switches, push buttons, and proximity sensors are to be connected. And the output module where the load devices such as relays, contactors, pilot lights, and solenoid valves are to be connected. We need a power cable for input voltage supply and a PLC communication cable, USB to SC09 connection. Note: power on the PLC equipment and make sure that the communication cable is connected at the laptop's USB port. Welcome to basic PLC programming. Let's use a Windows 10 64-bit operating system laptop and open the GX Developer PLC software. Click New Project, select PLC Series FX CPU, PLC Type FX2N, C, and click OK. The programming display for ladder logic will appear. These are the input and output programming icons to be used. We will create a simple logic program, start-stop control. Click Normally Open Contact or press F5, type X0, X is the prefix code for input devices. X0 will serve as the start push button. Next, add another Normally Open Input Contact, type X1, this will be the stop push button. Note that we use a normally open logic contact for stop push button because in actual connection of input devices, stop push button is a normally closed contact. Please refer to your motor control activities. And stop push button, NC, gives a logic 1 signal to the PLC. Click the coil icon or press F7, type Y0, Y is the prefix code for output devices. Y0 will serve as the load or output. Click or move the box at control 0. Add a maintaining or latch contact, click subrung normally open or press SF5, type Y0. In our programming display area, a gray color is visible. To remove the gray color, go to menu section, select convert, click convert, or press F4. Conversion gives you the signal if your ladder structure is free of bugs or errors. And let's do the PLC communication setup. At menu, select online, click transfer setup. A new tab display will appear. It is where you can set up the laptop to PLC communication by properly selecting the COM port number. COM port connection can be accessed at Device Manager tab. Go to search, type Device Manager and click. Look for the exact port number, the PLC cable is connected at COM4. Go back to PLC software interface and choose COM4. And click OK. Next, transfer the logic program to the PLC unit. Go to menu, select online, and click write to PLC. This process is also known as downloading. For your information, read from PLC is a process of transferring of logic programs from PLC to the computer, and also known as uploading. Click the video link above for a more detailed explanation of PLC's downloading/uploading processes. Check main, click program, select range type, step range. Type 4 at end box. That's the last logic control line. This process will allow a much faster logic transfer to the PLC unit. Click execute and don't forget to run the program. And click close. For PLC monitoring, go to menu, select online, click monitor and select monitor mode or press F3. Let's simulate the logic program. For the meantime, these toggle switches will be simulated as momentary push buttons. Switch on the start input device. As expected, the coil activates and form a latch control. Switch off the logic control program. To exit the PLC monitoring, you may stop it at online menu, or just simply press F2. To edit or write an additional program, go to menu, select edit, and click write mode or press F2. How about adding an on delay timer instruction to our program? Still, we will use this logic program and add more control lines. Press F5. Type Y0, click OK. This will energize the PLC timer. Press F7, type T0, space, K50. T is the prefix code for PLC timers, K50 means 50 multiplied by 100 milliseconds. And it will give us a 5-second time interval. Add a timer contact, press F5, type T0 and OK. And last, a load to be energized by timer 0. Press F7, type Y1, and click OK. To transfer the logic program to the PLC unit, just do the convert to monitoring procedures. And simulate the program. Press the start button, timer 0 energized. When the timer accumulates 50 time value or 5 seconds, Y1 or the output will be activated. And press stop button to deactivate the logic program. What if you are instructed to use only one real-world output instruction to be displayed in the PLC unit? How you're supposed to do that? You may modify the logic program by using its internal relay memory. Leave Y1 as it is, since it is the true real-world output out there. Just simply replace the Y0 input instructions by typing M0. M is the prefix code for internal memory. M0 will serve as the internal relay. And simulate the logic program. As you can see, the PLC unit displays a single output instruction. This method of using internal memories will help you save the output instructions for a more complex logic program. Aside from PLC timers and internal memory relays, we have the counter-up instructions. Go to Program Display Area, click Coil icon or press F7, type C0, space, K5. C is the prefix code for counters, K5 means 5 counts. Add an input instruction to give a logic signal to the counter instruction. Press F5, type X0, and OK. Counter instructions usually come with a reset instruction. Click Application Instruction icon or press F8, type RST, space, C0. RST is the prefix code for reset instructions. Add an input device to trigger the reset instruction. Press F5, type X1, and OK. Add a counter contact, press F5, type C0 and OK. And last, a load to be energized by counter 0. Press F7, type Y0, and click OK. Simulate the logic program. Press input instruction X0 5 times, to energize the output coil Y0. Press X1, to reset the logic program. An important reminder, in every logic program, do not remove the end instruction. So, that's all on how to do basic PLC programming by using GX Developer for your Mitsubishi PLC activities. If you find this video interesting and useful to others, you may consider subscribing, like and share and hit the notification bell for more updates to come. And follow us at Facebook, Facebook page, Warden's Corner. See you on next video tutorials. Have a nice day ahead. Thank you and goodbye.